Hey everybody, how are you doing? Hope you have been having good sessions that we've been doing these Wednesday nights. I think tonight is the night that we're going to start really focusing on Lama Yoga. And so Lama Yoga is a practice of meditation that was put forth in the degree lessons. It was given to Earlene Cheney by her teacher. And it is an important part of Astara. When you're doing the book lessons, that is one aspect, but the practices that come out of it are even more important. The thing is to be doing this on a regular basis, not just when you go through and read the book. And so we want to emphasize that you do this practice on a regular basis, you know, at least once a week. So we're going to go through the different steps or the different aspects of Lama Yoga. First, you are going to touch the tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth. Now, what that does when you touch the tip of the tongue to the roof of your mouth is you have an energetic channel that runs down the front and you have an energetic channel that runs through the back. And when you touch the tongue to the roof of the mouth, you're joining those two channels. So you become a better energy circuit. When you are starting to do this practice, more energy is going to be coming in, especially into the upper centers. Now, Lama Yoga is the practice of sustained awareness, right? Sustained awareness. So your tongue is going to be to the roof of your mouth. And then if you watch me for a second, there's this breath that you do where you put your chin down to your chest. Now, it's important that you touch the chin to the chest, or at least as close as possible, right? The more that you go down, the more that this activates the upper centers, right? So your head's going to be down. You're going to inhale through your nose. And then exhale through the mouth. So inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale through the nostrils. Exhale through the mouth. And you make kind of a little bit of a slight, like kind of hissing sound or just an exhalation sound with your mouth. You can push the breath through your teeth. Now, if you can, you keep your tongue to the roof of your mouth while you do this. So again, you inhale up, exhale down. Now, when you're down, part of what's happening when your head is down is you're activating the upper centers, right? Now, when your head is up like this, what you're doing is you're activating the lower centers, right? So you're activating the upper, then you're activating the lower, then you're activating the upper, you're activating the lower. So if you notice that sometimes when you're praying, your tendency is to do this, it's because it naturally activates some of the upper centers, right? It makes you more conductive. Now, part of what we're doing is we're cultivating sustained awareness, but you're also starting to move energy up and down the spine. Right? As you start to draw energy into your body from the environment, you're starting to draw energy in that will impact certain centers within the blood, right? So this is good. This is one of the steps, which we'll be talking about later as these study groups progress. But then the next step is to activate the centers along the spinal column. As you activate the centers along the spinal column, it makes it easier and easier for energy to move down towards your tailbone where it mixes with Kundalini. Kundalini is an energy that lays dormant in and around the basic chakra. Then that energy mixes and starts to move back up. As that moves up, the spine becomes more activated. All your energy centers become more activated. Now, your spiritual development is not how much energy comes down, it's actually how much energy that goes back up. Part of doing Lama Yoga is you're moving energy from the lower centers to the upper centers, right? If you look at the average person walking around, their lower centers are substantially more developed and there's more energy in them than their upper centers. We want to shift the balance of the energy being in our lower centers more to the upper centers. This is symbolized by the Egyptian symbol, the Ankh, right? The Ankh. If you look at the cover of the Astara lesson books, the degree lessons, there is an Ankh on the cover. This is part of the reason, is the Ankh helps to move energy up to the upper centers and transmute the lower, grosser energy that's in our lower centers. This helps us to be more spiritual, be more spiritualized, and it helps us to take control of the lower vehicle, right? So with this, as you go through and do this, this meditation is very calming, it's very peaceful, it accelerates your spiritual growth, and it increases and enhances sustained awareness, right? When you have greater levels of awareness, reflection, inner reflection becomes easier. The ability to process information that's in front of you also becomes easier. You process it rather than react to it, right? With reflection, there starts to become greater and greater levels of awareness. When we are on the spiritual path, we're really trying to engage or embrace an evolutionary process, or basically help affect change as we spiritually grow and evolve, right? As we spiritually grow and evolve, part of the evolutionary process is the ability to let go of what we're doing and move to something that's bigger and greater, something that's bigger and greater than ourselves, right? So we're trying to touch the divinity within, or touch our higher soul. And so our ability to perceive something and go, that is not me, I am the soul, becomes more and more crucial, right? So if you look at in the Catholic tradition, when they do the Hail Mary, the prayer for Hail Mary is sustained awareness. It's big forehead, big heart, right? When you do Lama Yoga, it's big forehead, big heart. Right. So with greater levels of awareness, we're able to then start to circulate energy in our body to a much greater degree, which means we're able to assimilate energy to a much higher degree. We're able to activate the Kundalini and move it up to a much higher degree. The key is awareness, right? Not focus, awareness. Having sustained awareness is a lot like keeping your car in between the two white lines. You're not focused on the white lines. You're just simply keeping your car between the two white lines, right? So if thoughts come up during this process, you watch them like you would watch clouds. Oh, look at that. I see what that is, but you pay attention to it. You're not needing to do anything. You're just being still. You're just being aware. Now, try to be as still as possible. Movement takes away from this process. Right? Now, we're going to do a trial run just so you can practice, right? So first off, just keep your eyes closed. Put your tongue to the roof of your mouth. Now, just touch it somewhere. You can start with behind the teeth and work your way back a little bit, but just make it comfortable. The really strong version of this is you touch the soft palate, which means you have to flip your tongue all the way back. But at first, maybe just touch it somewhere on the roof of your mouth. Okay, now put your chin down to your chest. You empty out your lungs. Inhale through your nose, up. Exhale through the mouth. Inhale up, 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 exhale through the mouth. Inhale up through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Just be still, be aware. Okay, so now at this point, you're just being still, you're being aware, you're gonna have a couple of things, right? You're more aware, so you'll start to practice awareness on the body. You pay attention to the body, you pay attention to how things feel, you pay attention to how the body is changing. The deeper part is you pay attention to the breath. You're not trying to control the breath, you're just monitoring the breath. You're just paying attention. you'll notice that your breath is very transient. Sometimes it's deep, sometimes it's shallow. Sometimes you inhale more, sometimes you exhale more. You're not trying to control it, you're just paying attention to it. Now, at times you might start to expand and have really deep experience of oneness, where you start to forget the form. Just allow it to happen. And if it starts to float away, just allow that to happen. When you start to have expansion in your meditation, you are going to go through a series of expansions and condensations, right? You'll expand, you expand, you expand, and then things will start to condense a little bit more. And if you watch it, you just keep watching it, eventually it starts to expand again, and the expansion becomes even greater, right? The key is to be able to watch it go back and forth. Sometimes what happens is we have the expansion, and then as we start to come into our body a little bit more, there starts to be condensation. We think, oh, meditation's over. But it's just how energy works. There's expansion, there's condensation. Just like your lungs, you inhale, you exhale. You inhale, you exhale. You have expansion, you have condensation. Expansion, condensation. Okay? Now, we can use a mantra for this. We can use a couple of different mantras. One is you can use the mantra Aum, Aum, A-U-M, right? This is a very powerful mantra. Part of what you're doing as you're going through and doing Lama Yoga is you're practicing sustained awareness. You're really starting to practice being aware of the inner sound, right? The inner sound or the inner Aum or Aum, right? The sound associated with the creative process. As you keep getting stiller and stiller, it becomes stronger and stronger, right? Sometimes it takes a little while, right? Later, we'll practice things to accelerate your process. But for right now, let's just practice this. Now, with that, we're also going to use a mudra. We're going to use a mudra, right? So now, take your left hand like so. Take your left hand like so. Now, take your right hand and make a T, right? So your right hand is on top. So now you're going to fold, and you're going to go like this, okay? So my right hand, my left hand is on top of my right hand. My left hand is on top of my right hand, right? So my left hand's here, my right hand's here, and then I fold and I go down, right? So I'm like this, right? So left, right, fold. Now this goes over your navel. This goes over your belly button. Now, hold this mudra over your belly button, keep your eyes closed, and your tongue on the roof of your mouth. Just by going through and doing this, do you notice something feels like it's starting to happen? Okay, so we're gonna pull all of this together and we're gonna do another run, okay? So now, left hand, right hand, fold your awareness, or excuse me, you put this on your navel. Keep your eyes closed. Your tongue is at the roof of your mouth. Just be still. Silently affirm, I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. I'm one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. Put your chin down to your chest. Inhale slowly up. Exhale through your mouth down. Inhale up. Exhale 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 down. Just be still. Keep your eyes closed. Just be still. Maintain the mudra. Maintain the tongue to the roof of your mouth. Keep your eyes closed. Again, your chin is down to your chest. Inhale slowly up. Exhale down slowly. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Just be still. Just be still. Be aware.
I don't know that.
Maintain your stillness and awareness. Be aware of your body. Be aware of your surroundings. Be aware of your breath. Be aware of your thoughts. Thank you. put your chin down to your chest. Inhale, moving your head up. Exhale, moving your head down. Inhale up. Exhale, 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 down. Just be still. Be still, be aware. Maintain your stillness. Don't control your breath. Just be aware of your breath. Be aware of your body. Be aware of your surroundings. Be aware of your thoughts. Don't try to control anything. Just be still. Maintain your stillness. Okay, wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. That is still a trial run. You're getting the idea. Some of you have already been doing this practice, but still, you're getting the idea, new and old timers, right? So now we're going to augment what we're already doing with a mantra. So as you inhale, silently, you're going to go ling. And as you exhale, you're going to just let your breath go. And you're going to go ha. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Right? So the ling is silent in your head. You're just silently going to go ling. It's not a quick ling. It's almost the whole length of the head movement, right? So you're going to go ling. So it'll look like this. But internally, you're going ling ho, Ling ho. Ling ho. Ling ho. Right? So that's one mantra. The next one, one of the part of the Astarian hierarchy is a being named Rama. Rama. So you're going to go Ra internally, silent. And then just gently, you're going to go Ma. Ra. Ma. Ra. Ma. Both of these make you more conductive. Both of these start to activate things in your brain, different sides of your brain. One, the first one does it more on the right side of the brain. The second one, a little bit more on the left side of your brain. Okay, so I'll guide you through and we're gonna do the same practice, but now with a mantra. So again, your tongue is to the roof of your mouth. Your left hand is here, your right hand is here. You're making a little circle. It's about egg-shaped. It goes over your navel. Your eyes are closed. Chin down to your chest. Ready? Inhale. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Ling ha, ling ha, ling ha, ling ha. Just be still, keep your eyes closed. Put your head down again. Ling ha. Head up. Ling ha. Inhale. Ling. Exhale. Ha. Ling ha. Ling ha. Ling ha. Ling. Ha. Just be still. Be aware. Keep your eyes closed. Maintain your stillness and awareness. Chin down to your chest. This time we're going to do Ra and then Ma. Ready? Inhale up, Ra. Down, Ma. Up, Ra. Ma, ra, ma, ra, ma, ra, ma, ra, ma, ra, ma. Just be still. Be aware. chin back to your chest. Inhale, raw, head going up. Exhale, ma. Inhale up, raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Just be still. Be aware. Chin back down to your chest. Ling ha. 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 Just be still, be aware. Put your hand down to your head down to your chest. Inhale, raw. Exhale, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Raw, ma. Just be still. Maintain your stillness and awareness. Meditate on the space or the gap of the mantra. Just listen to the chant. Just be still. Om. Keep your eyes closed. Gently put your chin back down to your chest. Inhale, moving your head up. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Ling. Ha. Ling, ha, ling, ha, ling, ha, ling, ha. Just be still, be aware. Maintain your stillness and awareness. Chin down to your chest. Inhale, ra. Exhale, ma. Ra. Ma. Ra. Ma. Ra. Ma. Just be still. Maintain your stillness. Maintain your awareness. Meditate on the space or the gap of the mantra. Just let go. Om. Gently wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. How do you feel? Let's have you type in and just share how you're doing, how you're feeling.
Centered. I like when I went to another world.
Centered, and it felt like you went to another world. Yeah. Very good. Good for you. Yeah.
Didn't want to come back.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a very nice, peaceful place. And the thing is like if you practice this on a consistent basis, it starts to become easier and easier to be aware of your higher faculties and your higher soul and what is of the lower nature or the lower vehicles and what is of the higher soul and the higher nature. And so it becomes easier and easier for you to differentiate between the lower and the upper and you to act on the things that are more appropriate for you. It also starts to activate clairvoyance. It starts to activate intuition and inner guidance.
Someone literally just said that. They said physical body, detached, incarnated soul was there and higher soul was watching.
Yeah, very good. Very aware. Very, very good.
I feel very relaxed, very peaceful and stillness.
this is a great thing for us to be practicing now as we come into the time of Christmas. You know, it becomes like easier in a way to become spiritualized during the beginning of the holidays all the way through Easter. And so this practice becomes very, very important during this time. And so with that, this isn't going to be the only time we practice it, but we might be adding some different things to it or doing other things, you know, and then doing this as well. But we're going to start consistently doing this meditation. It really starts to become the bread and butter of the Astara practice. So there's going to be a lot of other things that are built upon this practice of Lama Yoga. So with that,
Could you explain why the experience of like the physical body feeling detached and the incarnated soul was there and the higher soul was watching?
Yeah, you are becoming more aware, and just when the heart becomes aware and the forehead and the upper centers become aware, you start to be clearer about what is of the lower nature and what is of the higher soul. You do start to become the watcher of the lower vehicles. As you start to do this, what's starting to happen is you are disentangling from the lower nature. You could say it like this. The lower stories, the dramas, the normal everyday life entanglements become easier and easier to disentangle from. So the regular practice starts to increase your ability of what is like true and what is just like a story or drama or the things from the day. And so it becomes easier and easier for you to detach, which means greater expansion in your meditations, greater ability to integrate spirituality in your normal everyday life. And when the time comes for your transition, when you leave the body, you'll be able to disentangle to a much greater degree and go up to the higher realms at a much faster rate. So in a way, you get to experience the bliss while you're in your life, but then after, when it's time to leave the body, your level of development that happens at your passing becomes highly, highly increased. So you're kind of preparing for now and you're preparing for later. The more that you identify with the soul now will start to change how you act and think in the normal everyday life. And so that's what's starting to happen in that meditation. You were having a direct experience with that.
How many times can we practice in a week?
You could do this 2 or 3 times a week. Yeah, you could easily do this 2 or 3 times a week. You know, basically you could kind of do it every other day. So yeah, good for you guys. I'm really enjoying doing this thing with you guys every Wednesday night. So I hope you're enjoying as well. And I love being able to talk about the different practices for Astara. So it's been very nice. So, okay, you guys, well, we're going to call it. I don't want to keep you guys too long. I want to give you something, but not have it consume a whole night. So we're trying to always keep it to right around 50 minutes or an hour so that we can, you know, keep a consistent interaction with you guys. So until next week. Practice if you can, and if not, we'll be doing it again soon. And we'll also be having a recording of this for you shortly. So, okay. So we will talk to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.